Hello and welcome to New Frost Morphs. Today we're going to be carrying out an inspection. Jared, tell me a little bit about what you've been up to over the last 24 hours.
So we did a spy camera on some of the breeding snakes to catch them breeding, which there's a video that's just been put out.
I understand it's been well received.
Am I
right?
Hopefully. I hope people like it because I think it's pretty cool. Never seen it before happen, so if you want to see snakes breeding in fast motion, check it out.
Wow. So what time lapse. What inspired you to do that, Jared?
Well, I think someone said they'd like to see it on a comment that you got.
Yeah.
And tried it out.
Yeah. I think Steve Beckett and Joey, they picked up on one of our videos that I was thinking about putting in a head camera into there, and they loved the idea, and we ran with it. And the reason why this video is one day late is because we had success on our locks. Now, how many pairs did we put out, Jared?
We had 4 pairs out.
Have you ever had 100% locking?
I think, yeah.
Have we? All pairs have all locked?
Yeah, when I just spread one.
So when we did one, but we put 4, how many of the 4 actually locked?
All 4.
We had 100% success within 6 hours. Now, was it anything to do with the feeding?
Don't know.
Remember the Jedi's fed that Monday. We think we may have left some Jedi power in the food. Either that, or someone's been going around putting in powdered Viagra into the male's water. I don't know which one would be the case. It's probably more likely it was Jedi power, Jared.
Knowing you, it's probably Viagra.
No, I don't need Viagra, Jared.
Anyway, let's see.
Remember, I'm the Italian stallion here, so...
Right.
So, let's have a look. Now, what happened? Normally, we don't check the same day when we lock, which is a big mistake. You should check after a few hours to see how they're doing. And I think the reason why we've had 4 out of 5 locks is because we could well have had 5 locks without realizing it, because we've not been diligent in doing the reviews. So one of the Jedi tips is to give them a chance to settle down. I've looked very carefully at the video footage on the cam lock, and being a Jedi Knight, I wanted to suggest putting one extra letter into your description of your cam lock, because I know you're going to do it every week. But being a Jedi Knight, could we put an A in the middle of cam and lock?
Locker cam? What?
In the middle. Can you put an A in the middle of cam and lock?
Camelot.
Camelot. Jedi Knight, Camelot.
I don't get it.
The Knights of Camelot. Was it Camelot was a knight?
Camelot. Yeah, King Arthur.
King Arthur, yes. But he was a knight, wasn't he? So I was thinking Camelot might be play on words.
I think you're stretching it a bit there.
It's what I call intelligent humour. You have to be at another level, Joe, to really get my humour. It's the kind of humour that Mandy likes. She doesn't like
IQ humour.
Well, I've got slapstick humour, as everyone knows, but today Mandy and I had a heart-to-heart. She wants me to be more intelligent with my humour, so I'm going to try and accommodate her needs and give you some intelligent humour. You probably won't enjoy it as much, but some of you might, but we'll see where we go. Anyway, without any further ado, as I like to say, let's have a look at the pairs first, Jared. We've done all the cleaning this morning.
Yep.
Where are we first of all? So we've got Jupiter, and let's see if they've relocked. I'm not expecting them. I'm expecting them to be separated now, but let's see what happens. Anything going on, Jared?
I don't think so.
Can you see how they're dirty separated. The rub's become over just 24 hours? They've tipped over that water bowl. Yeah. She's on top of him. They look really happy and comfortable. I'm reading that body language. I think the clown boy has had a night to remember.
In this caught on camera.
Yeah, and he shed out the night before, so he was wearing his best DJ. So when he was going dining, he wined and dined. And now Rob gave us some beautiful feedback, and he's given us an interpretation of his take on the first one of these series, and I'm going to share that with you a bit later. But I think what we'll do is we've got some other plans for the clown boy. Where are we going to put him?
To the cinnamon girl.
So we're going to now separate them. We're happy to separate them. Some people can leave them in for 2 days. So we're now moving from taking him out of here, and we're going to move him into another female. Because he's 2.5 kilograms, he could have service 5 girls comfortably. But he's only looked after one so far this week. So let's do that. Let's very carefully, gently does it, because they still, you know, we've got to follow the will of the animal. So I'll do this very gently. If they resist, I'll leave them in. I won't force my will on them. If they're relaxed about me moving them, then I'll move them. So that's the key, is not to impose your will. Find out how they respond to this. Let's look at behavior. Well done, Joker. Well done, Jupiter. Yeah, they're not locked. So he's comfortable being removed because he knows he's probably got another hot date with the lady and the cinnamon girl, Jared. Why have you decided to put Joker in with the cinnamon girl?
We want to get some cinnamon clowns.
Yeah, how close is she to ovulating, do you think?
I think she's pretty close.
So this could be her last opportunity, is what you're saying?
Yeah, we thought we'd get a bit of fresh sperm in there just in case.
Yeah, now he's already carrying lots of hormones from his previous night out, so that might stimulate her to let him come in for one more time. And we'll just gently put them in, close them down, and let him explore the girl. And then, shall we put the... We'll keep that. I've recharged the head cam, so on the next pairing, we'll try a different male and get a different behaviour on the next one. We'll do a second video for everybody, if you enjoy it. I'll just wash my hands, and we'll get the other head camera. What's the other pairing you want to do, Jared?
The other ones that we've got to do are the banana is going into the calico.
Yes. And? Any other pairings? Were you going to put the cinnamon in?
Cinnamon pied.
Where's the cinnamon pied going?
I think he's going into the 100% head pied. I have to double check.
Okay, so let's do the cinny pied, and I've got the head camera charged again. We have to do a setup for that.
Cinnamon pied, yeah, to Phoenix.
So where is the cinnamon pied, Jared?
He is in here at the moment. Oh no, he's not. He's in here at the moment.
Are they together locking up, or what's going on in here?
I think they're finished with their lock.
But they're tail-to-tailing, so you might want to get them longer. Thursday.
They had a good lock the other day, so...
Yeah, but I look at that and think their tails are together. I'm going to leave that. That tells me my Jedi forces are telling me to leave another day. Okay. Because this girl's only just got up to size. She's not had many locks.
Yeah, she has.
How many locks has she had, Jared?
She's had a lot. It's this one that hasn't had many.
Right.
That's the yellow belly pied.
And where do you want to put him?
He was going to go in with the het pied. Because he's already just locked just now. So that lock's done. They don't really need to be together anymore.
Okay then. Let's follow your instincts, Jared. The camera up there. So I've washed my hands and I'll just see how they look. He's sissing at me, which could be a sign he doesn't want to be moved, but he does siss this one. Elvis is, there we go, look. Are you right, fella?
Yeah, he's done his job.
He's done his job. So let's just move him on to the next then. Right, Jan, if you'd like to do the draw. Now she looks big, Jared, really big.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna gently put them in. Without disturbing them too much. That's key, is to be as gentle as you can when you put them together. And do you want the head cam in that one, or do you want it in the other one?
It's probably worth putting in another one.
Okay, I'll wash my hands, then tell me the next one you want me to do.
Next one's the banana.
Banana boy. Now he's starting to show signs of going into shed. He's not in shed, but he's just starting to turn, Jared. So we have to be discerning as to whether or not we try him or not. So when you've got an animal that is just starting to turn, you've got to make a judgment call. When we cleaned him, he was looking for a female, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Where do you want to put him, Jared?
So he's got to go in with the calico.
Calico. She could do with another lock. They've had three locks, but I'd like her to have another.
It's the calico.
Yeah. She's getting quite big as well, isn't she? She took a multi, that means that her follicles are growing and she's stepping down her size of food. So let's just see the reaction of putting these two together. So I would love to video these two, but let's just see how they get on. Look, he's showing an interest. There you go, big fella. See how you get on. You've got my favourite calico girl to love there. And was that the last three, Jared?
And the last one's the leopard.
Leopard, now.
So the pastel clown.
The leopard is doing really well. We've moved him up a little bit, haven't we? So the leopard Mowgli, I'll just wash my hands.
He's in here, hiding underneath his
bed. He's looking stunning, Jared, isn't he, beautiful? Since we've been putting in the extra humidity, what I call humidity pads, everything's doing even better because the humidity's gone up another 10 degrees. And I think they like that extra step up because it gets quite dry when you have a high ambient temperature in here. You've got to constantly be spraying down the rubs. You can't just leave it, particularly if not using coca husk. We have bought some coca husk that we're going to treat one or two of our snakes in the quarantine area with to see whether that will help. But there's some good news on the snake that had the RI from the import that we got. He's starting to improve, Jared, and I've been nurturing him every day with the new methods. but I want to talk about a natural method of medicine that doesn't involve any man-made substances. It's all nature, and I've got a new idea that I wanted to discuss with you, Jared, on how we can treat any snakes that come down with issues. So where's this one going to go?
Pastel clown.
So pastel clown is Amber. This is Mowgli. How's she looking, Jared? Make sure she's clean and all good to receive him. And then we'll put you in there, big fella. There you go. There's your woman for the night. And make us some leopard clowns. Pastel leopard clowns would be nice.
Super
pastel leopard clowns is what we could shoot for there. With a chance, because he's 50% het pied, if he proves out to be 100% het pied, we could end up with killer clowns with leopard in them. And they could be 50% pied if he proves out to be 100%. Now that would be an awesome combination. Would you not agree, Jared?
Yeah, it would be cool.
We'd love it. So you have my blessing. I'm going to blow you a kiss, guys. I'm going to blow you kisses in the air. Go do your business, Mowgli. Go and have some jungle warfare. So
then we've got to separate some more pairs that were together.
These locked, I saw them locked yesterday. Now that could be her final lock.
That's a leopard albino, 100% het pied, to a pied, 100% het albino.
Yeah, so Cookie can go and rest now.
So hopefully we'll get some leopard albino pies from them, which would be wicked.
Yeah. So let's just move him into there. She can stay in there. And I think that's everything now, is it, Jack?
There's one more we've got to separate.
One more. Okay, so we've got Cookie. Where's Cookie's rod? There he is. Now, we use the yellow tagging system to help us find things a lot easier. And we can take those yellow tags off once we separate.
Put it on the
and
banana.
Then we move them onto the banana, don't we? So we're moving around.
Last one is the mocha and the ultramel.
Just wash my hands.
I think they're unhooked, but we'll double check. Yeah, they're unhooked.
Are they unhooked? Good. It was lovely to see the ultramel locking to the mocha because I think she needed a final lock. And then we'll pull him out. Does he need to go anywhere else or can we rest him?
He's rest now. He's locked everything this month.
Fantastic.
So he gets a nice couple of weeks rest until next month.
Let's give him a nice rest, Jared. He is a lovely boy, isn't he?
And they live right next to each other, next door neighbours.
Next door neighbours, having an affair with his neighbour. There he is. Let's just show him off to the camera because he's such a beauty, Jared. He is one of my favourite males. Just look how gorgeous he is. He's starting to move into shed. I'm looking at him and he looks like he might be moving into shed, Jared. Look at the belly.
Yeah.
You see the brown turning up? So we just squeezed him in just before shed time. Well done. Well done. You are a gorgeous animal, Titus. And he's eating small rats while he's been breeding all the way through. That's why he's packing on weight still. But he's absolutely maturing beautifully. An absolute star. So I think that's all the breeding. Hopefully everyone's enjoying the snakes. Lots of snakes going on here in this video. Let's have a little chat, Jared, at the table. And then we'll put the head cam in later. We won't bore everyone with that. Just remember to put that in later, Jared.
Yeah.
And I'll get my glasses and we'll have a little chat about some of the feedback that we've had. Just wash my hands. So today we're going to be talking about two Jedi powers, Jared. One of them is the lightning power. And the other one is mind tricks. When to use them, when to not use them. And we're going to discuss how to use them within a ball python setup as well, Jared. Do you want a chair?
Sure.
Get that out of the way. There you go. I'm going to get Jared to build me a wardrobe because we've got so many costumes at the moment. We need to have a little mini wardrobe in here, Jared. And I was thinking, because I'm into my gardening, growing vegetables, Jared, this could be the perfect environment to start growing seeds.
Nah.
We've got so much space. I was thinking just for my germination, because I like to, just at the top tip for anyone that likes their garden, this is the time to start germinating your seeds. And if you've got seeds ready to go, then you want a nice environment like this to be perfect with the early germination, Jared. Plus also the seeds will give off oxygen into the air. So it could actually be positive to your snakes. But let anyone know if you've got any views about that one. But we're talking about going completely organic here.
Personally, I say don't clutter it up.
Yeah, it is a bit
cluttered. It's only a bit cluttered with your wardrobe stuff.
My wardrobes and costumes? Yes, we need to get that organised, Jared. Otherwise, if you're not careful, darling, we're going to end up with a real mess in here. But we don't want a messy facility because a tidy facility, this is our temple. The tidier the temple, the better we feel. So, first of all, before we go on to these two superpowers, just to give our thanks to all of the lovely people that have given us such lovely messages. How much time do we have on the clock, Jared?
You've had 17 minutes.
17 minutes, so I've got time to share these. The first one is a message from Rob at Royal Balls. Thank you, Rob, for showing an interest in our snake cam. So he calls it a spy cam, I think. It's a spy on things. So anyway, when he watched it, he was just amazed. He said, if I may use your words, snake porn. Great big exclamation mark. Awesome footage there with some notable takeaways. So I like the term there, takeaways. We're not talking about Chinese here, Jared. We're talking about what can you gain from the footage in terms of increasing your knowledge. And this is Rob's take on what he saw. And everyone will see it differently. Some people can look at the footage and think, oh, that's boring. Others would be very intrigued and interested to see actually what happens. So let's see Rob's take on this. The first thing that surprised me was how long they took to get through the foreplay. Now, I have observed that locks within minutes of the male going in, all the way through to locks to the second day, but usually it's quite a short time in my experience with not much small talk prior to getting to business. So that was his first point, which is a valid point. Any idea why it took them a while to get going, Jared?
I don't have an idea, no.
Well, my thoughts are that he had shed out, so he was wearing his best dinner jacket, he didn't want to get messy too early. She had a nice clean rub. Now normally it's nice to have a little bit of poo, a little bit of shed in there, lots of hormones, so that when they go in, the instant hormone connects and they are straight onto it. I mean, everything just kicks off. But if you've got too clinical a rub, you've got to give your animals a chance to create the atmosphere. So you've got to get the candlelit supper prepared, music in the background. You've got to have beautiful perfumes coming through the air. You've got to set the scene, my darling, for your love scene. Everything's got to be done. So this is a little bit of marriage counselling coming up here and a bit of sex education. If you want to improve your relationship with your partner, prepare yourself, you know. Like, if you take the Joker, he had a full shed before he came. He was looking pristine, he was looking great, healthy, stud looking. And then he took his time, and when we get into the footage, you'll see that he didn't rush in there and make love and it was all over within 2 seconds. He wined and dined her and brought her on, and she invited him in. And we'll see Rob's interpretation, then I'll give you my take on it. So the next point that Rob makes here, number two takeaway, second takeaway, is your female has been off food for a while, so no poo. Good point. There might have been some dirty talk, but certainly no poo. Oh, this is an insight into Rob's love life, I think. Maybe not.
I hope not.
We're going to have some fun when we come and visit you, Rob, I tell you. It's going to be fun. There might have been some dirty talk, but certainly no poo. Obviously, we cannot smell what the snakes smell. And I think a lot of what's happening in foreplay is chemical. He didn't bring the wine to lighten the mood, so I'm guessing he brought his own love potion with him. Oh yes, love potion, darling. Dinner wasn't out on the table, so she must have prepared something else to lure him in. Probably one of my spinners or my fishing tackle, maybe, I don't know. What do you think she would have done to lure him in then, Jared? What do women do to lure us in?
You have to start filming yourself.
I think we're going to move on very quickly here. This could, like you say, digress very quickly from what we want to do, but I'm finding it very... I love Rob's humour here. It's all done in tongue-in-cheek, isn't it? So the third takeaway is that physical contact is a good sign in any courtship, which is very true. And there was a lot of physical contact going on there. And if I would show you the slowed down version, you would have seen just how much physical contact. But I gave you everything 50 times the speed of... Everything virtually was 50 times the speed. So it was done fast time lapse so that 3 hours of footage was put into 8 minutes. Now, if your snakes retreat to opposite ends of the tub and curl up as far away from each other as possible, this is the human equivalent of bum to bumming it. Now, that never happened in that video. They didn't bum to bum it. It was very interesting that the girl did put her head in the corner and she didn't turn around while it was all going on. She just had her head in the corner. I've never seen that behavior before. Now, I don't know whether that's typical of most snakes or whether she was just showing respect to her mate, but there's certainly interesting behavior. If your snakes retreat to the opposite ends of the tub and curl up as far away from each other, this is the human equivalent to bum to bumming it. And that means rejection. So I guess if you study what's going on and they're not giving body contact and they are going to the opposite corners and they're not putting themselves together, then you've got to do one of two things. You either give them a bit more time, but if it ain't going to happen, there's no point in wasting the time on that one. Maybe they're just not compatible, because they don't. Not every snake's compatible, Jared. And not every snake's ready to go. So they do let each other know if they're not up for it, and they respect each other's wishes. No one, I don't think anybody forces anyone on anything there. So let's see what else is going on. Now, in the spirit of the rhythm of the room, now this is the next point it says here. It says that if the snakes are crawling all over each other, then love is in the air. Love is in the air. Love is in the air. I can feel a song coming on. Now, in the spirit of the rhythm of the room, this X-rated porno movie needs to be shown to all your breeder snakes just prior to pairing them up. Leave it on loop replay on the snake in the snake room TV all night the next time you're pairing up. So what Rob's recommending is we should be putting our YouTube video on when we leave the facility, Jared, just to help them get into the rhythm. But how many snakes have we put out? Three today. So four yesterday and three. We're not doing it individually. We're adding to the rhythm of the room. There's still hormones in this room from last night. And I think the interesting behavior is the other males were showing an interest. Like the banana boy was wanting to come out to search for a female. He's smelling hormones and he wants to engage. So when you start off with a big stud like Joker that creates the atmosphere and everything, it's a chain reaction. Now you build on that momentum. The mistake would be to wait another 3 days and then start again. But you'll notice we're using new males. We're using Joker because he's got the ability to see two girls comfortably within a couple of days. And everything's balanced. The force is in balance here. And that feels comfortable. Are you feeling comfortable with it, Jared?
Yeah.
Yeah? So you're now following your instincts.
With the snakes, yeah.
With the snakes. Hopefully you're feeling comfortable with you doing this sex education. So a big thank you to Rob for showing such a lovely interest in what we're doing. And it really made my day. I laughed my head off when I saw that, when I woke up in the morning and I saw that feedback. I was laughing my head off because I'm beginning to see Rob's got a very nice sense of humour here. I find him quite funny. So thank you very much. Now I'm going to give you my response now in the last 5 minutes. So I said, I'm giggling with laughter this morning, Rob. I love your interpretation and humour. Just wish I had four cameras so I could have captured all the breeding pairs simultaneously, because that would have been interesting to see how everyone else got to their locks. The good news is that all the pairs locked. For the first time, I've had 100% lock-up in under 6 hours. Chemistry in the room must have permeated through to the other pairs. I love the takeaways and the surprises too. The lack of poo in the rubs was good for the camera and our viewing, because can you imagine if they would have pooed and weed on our camera? You would never got those clean images. So that was good. Joker certainly had a few tricks up his sleeve. Whining and dining, kissing and cuddling eventually led to them locking. Joker even put on his best DJ for her, having just shed out the night before. He must have looked perfect to her. I do wonder if they send signals to each other at night time before we lock up. And she may have been picking up a heat signature from the camera before we started. Do you remember that? She checked out the camera. So she was feeling heat from that. Could be interesting if she tries to breed with my camera. That would be very interesting. Jared must have slipped some powdered Viagra in the water bowls.
Oh, really?
The night before. Oh,
playing the blame game now.
Either that or ANA-KING-COBRA must have left his magic with them during Monday's feeding night. Either way, the force was at work for sure. There we go, that was my response. So I hope you enjoyed my response, guys. Bit of fun, bit of banter. This just gives us a little bit of time to give out a few more shout outs, and then part two we'll get into the serious stuff, which is the two forces that I wanted to share with you. So the first thing, as I wanted to say, is that we had Paul Langston, my nephew, who loved the pure banter on the Macho Libero video, which half of you loved and half of you hated, but Paul loved it. And he told me that his dad, Tony, was in hysterics laughing at that film. Now, I think I better explain to people, if you haven't seen Nacho Libro.
Libre.
Libro. Libre. Yeah. If you haven't seen the movie, go see it first and then re-look at the video, because we did our best to try and take the mickey out of the character, didn't we, Jared? And in fact, Jared knows that character better than I did, but he didn't have the guts to do it, did you, Jared?
No, I just had what's the word?
You had all the...
I care too much about myself. To let myself be seen like that.
So
I'll allow that to be your forte.
Okay, well, can I let them into a little secret, Jared? Where did I get the costume?
I wore it for a Halloween costume.
Jared was wearing that
was with friends. That wasn't for the world to see.
Jared, I got that count. I'm going to let everyone know that Jared really, he's that. He wanted to be the macho Libra, really, but he didn't quite have that determination to do it. So I had to step in with Jared's help.
I had the self-respect. That's the word I was looking for.
But I wanted to dress up as a nun so we could do a proper double act.
No.
Sister act.
No. But I need another employee.
Anyway, we've really got a little bit of time. I must get these shout-outs out. So thank you, Paul, for your lovely banter. And actually, you might have known that we're in our busy tax return period at the moment, and we're almost getting to the end now. But we pushed the live feed back from tonight to next week, just to let everyone know, in case you're getting excited about live feed. Having said that, I got a text from my other nephew, Joe, who FaceTimed me yesterday, and he said that he would like to do a live with me and my other two cousins. Now, they're going to come back to me tonight to let me know if they're up for it. If not, we'll bring them on later. So let me know, guys, if you're up for it. We've got Matthew, Joe, and Paul could be giving us some really good banter tonight if they're up for it. If not, we've got James and Kaz and their family. And I'm not sure. Lewis is quite close to them and they're good friends. I'll let you guys work it out. If you want to bring Lewis in on a second Zoom, we could have Kaz and James giving us their Zoom with their family. And we could have Lewis on the other side. And me in the middle with Batman, and we could have a three-way conversation, three-way banter, and Lewis could share his collection, and James and Kaz could share me their collection, and I can enjoy spending time with both families. But if you don't want to do that, I understand. We could do Lewis separately and Kaz and James separately. So that'll be next week, so put that in your diary for next Thursday at 7. And the last thing I wanted to say in the last minutes was thank you to Wayne, to Hamlin, to Joe, Steve, and James, and Lewis. They loved the locking video that we put out yesterday. They all loved it, and they said they just thought it was brilliant, and they thought it was great to capture the locks. Wayne said it was good to capture the locks. Hamlin thought it was possibly a world's first. No one else has ever done that and put it on YouTube, and probably maybe. And Joe reckons it should go viral, and I think James loves it so much. So we shall see you in part 2. It's goodbye from the Jedi, and he shall return in 5 minutes.